with her speech entitled Learning to Sign. Learning to Sign, Sam Evans.
And then D, it actually looks like a D as well. And then we have E, because that's one of the vowels. And then F looks nothing like F, but that's okay. And I like G. And then H, you just have to rub your hand across the top like that. And then I, obviously one of the vowels. And then to do J, you actually just trace your finger along your palm in the shape of a J. And then K, it kind of looks a little bit like a K. L, so L is one finger. And then M is three. And then N is two. And then we go back to O, one of the vowels. And a P looks like a P. And Q, you put your finger through here, it actually looks like a Q. And R. And then to do S, you put your pinky on this pinky. And T looks like a T. And then U is the last one of our vowels. And V, we do a V on our palm. W, like this. X, very easy one. Y, we put our hand here. And then Z. Okay, so that's the alphabet. And you might be wondering how one person is still going to understand that. So, Craig has really nicely volunteered to be my volunteer. So when I used to speak to Michael, if you can please grab my hands. That's right, you just hold them like that, you just cup them like that. So if I was speaking, just loosely so I can move them, if I was speaking, he would actually feel what I was doing with my hands and he would literally be able to understand what I was doing. So on the sheet behind that, there's actually another step of signing. So Michael's father, Dan, he actually used to do this method instead, and I didn't learn this by myself. So in order to communicate, Michael would hold his hand up like that, and Stan would actually do the alphabet on his fingers and spell it all out, and so that's how he would communicate, and he'd do it really, really quick, and it was really quite phenomenal, and yeah, Michael would understand it. So thank you very much for that. So that's a brief introduction in how you do sign language to someone who is both blind and deaf. So you may never need to learn that ever, ever again, or it may come in really handy one day if you're ever on a game show or whatever, and it might actually even inspire you to help out at a volunteer place for the blind and deaf, or if none of those apply, you can at least do an hour home to your partners tonight and tell them that you can do sign language and they can't. So.